Welcome to the Late Picture with your host, Matt Bickerton, and his co-host, Matthew Adams.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Late Pick Show. We got a great show lined up for you guys tonight. Good stuff happening tonight. We got a Pepsi versus Coke taste test coming up. Doesn't sound exciting, but it will be. We got some other great stuff. We got a magician. What's he all about, Adams?
Well, he calls himself the Great Zucchini. We'll see how that relates. See how, why he's called the Great Zucchini. All that junk.
Maybe he'll even do some magic tricks for us while he's at it. Lopsided and Balding are here to play their new song. Give it up for Lopsided and Balding. And I think we're going to learn how to make a cake. Maybe even ninja style. I don't know. The director's a little fuzzy on that. But Adams, how you been doing lately?
Been doing pretty good. Been flying free. Been doing a little bit of a movie.
Are you going to tell us a little about that later?
Oh, yeah. It's going to be great.
I'm excited. This is the first I've heard of it. It may even go against his contract, but we'll find out later. So there's a bunch of good stuff happening tonight. We've got all this great stuff on the show. We hope you enjoy it. We might even be giving away some free stuff at the end of the show during the credits. Everyone here wants some free stuff, I think, don't they?
Yeah!
Some nice Late Big Show merchandise. You want to fill us in on some of the things we have tonight, Adams?
Well, the Pepsi is going to be great. I talked to him backstage. He's very excited. He's got this other guy. I don't know. Didn't see him much. He was in like a bag or something.
He's in a bag?
He was kicking.
Well, at least he's alive. Jeez, holy crap. Okay, so yeah, when we come back, we're going to have a Pepsi versus Coke taste test. So we're going to go to commercial right now. And when we come back, Pepsi versus Coke.
When nature calls, it calls hard and fast. For soothing relief, get Unky Straw's Tummy Reliever.
I should use Unky Straw's Tummy Reliever.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. If you're just joining us, we've got a Pepsi versus Coke taste test lined up, and Adams is going to tell us. Adams is gone. I don't know where he went, so I'm just going to send us right to this taste test, and we're going to find out all about it right now.
Oh, I didn't see you there. Hello. You arrived just in time to make this amazing, amazing Pepsi versus Coke taste test challenge to see which one will be the victorious Coca-Cola. Is my favorite. I think it's gonna win. It is the carbonated drink of the gods. It shall win this competition, but I'm not biased. This is a completely fair test. Everyone will be overjoyed. All right, what we gotta do, we're gonna have two cups. We're gonna have one filled with one, the other with the other one. We're gonna give our volunteer a little bit. We only have one volunteer. It's a very intricate process, I have to tell you, to get this volunteer ready for action. But now we're going to show you a clip of how we got this volunteer and the rigorous process it takes to get volunteers into this program.
Excuse me, sir, would you like to?
No.
Are you sure?
Yes.
Get him!
Thank you.
I didn't see you there. All right. Now that you know how we got these gracious yet spiteful volunteers ready for action, we can introduce you to one. Here is our volunteer. Isn't he a fabulous specimen? He's great. All right. Now, let's meet him. Let's get him. Let's get in there. So I hear you're a student.
Go to hell.
All right. Perfect. Now, we're going to go with these two glasses. We've got two glasses here. One with Coke, one with Pepsi. We don't know which one. It's going to be great. It's going to be crazy fabulous.
Get away from me.
Are you ready?
Get away.
He's ready. All right. Glass number one. All right. Perfect. Perfect. All right. And number two. All right. You ready for this action? That's crazy. Good. Good job. Good job. Proud of you, boy. All right. Which one did you like best?
The second one.
Which one?
The second one.
Which one?
Okay, the first.
Perfect. That's exactly right. The first one was Coca-Cola. I win. Bet. Ernie, you owe me money. All right, so Coca-Cola is the victor. This is our volunteer.
You'll burn for this.
And now, back to you.
That was sadistic, yet entertaining. I wonder if I could just have a quick word with the scientist whose mind is behind this. Are there any legal implications to your collecting of these specimens? Like,
oh, the government doesn't know. Not at all. Not in the least.
You're not at all worried that one of them might be watching the show right now?
Oh, right. We have all our permits in order.
What
the HDC and DCP.
What happened to, you said you had more contestants. What happened to them? Why do we only have one?
Those ones. Yeah, the thing about that is, they're all dead. Had to euthanize them. No other choice. That's it.
You euthanized dozens of other human beings?
Hundreds.
Hundreds?
Thousands.
Thousands of people.
Mm-hmm.
I'm speechless with horror and fright, and we're going to go to commercial. I'm probably not going to be calling the police. Don't worry about that, but we're going to go to commercial now, so here we go. And welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. That was Lopsided and Balding who played you in there. And now, as we forgot to mention at the beginning of the show, we're going to be talking to the proprietors of Unky Straw's Music Emporium. We're here with Mike Gannon right now, the owner of that store. And I think he's got a little clip for us about the store.
I've got clips for everyone all around. Clips about the music store.
All right, so we're going to go. We're going to see one of those clips right now, and we'll find out what Unky Straw's Music Emporium is all about.
Slashing the prices. Come on over. We got amps, rack modulators, synthesizers, MIDI controllers and keyboards. We got them all. We got your Fenders, Ibanez, Squires, Epiphones, and Takaminis, and many more.
Well, that was a pretty interesting clip. That was Unky Straw's Music Emporium, and I have to say, it looks kind of small for a music emporium.
Well, everyone says size matters, but not in the music world. The only thing that matters in the music world is the size of your brain and the length.
Well, wouldn't you say in the music world the talent also applies? I mean, to make it, you need... Oh, wait a minute. No, you don't. Not these days.
Not these days. Not with girls like Hilary Duff and Lindsay Lohan going around with their pretty bodies.
I'm sure you wouldn't catch them in Unky Straw's Music Emporium, would you?
Hell no.
So, what kinds of things does Unky Straw's Music Emporium do? Do they just sell guitars, or...?
Oh, no. We do not only just sell guitars. We also repair guitars. We teach lessons on playing guitars.
Oh, you teach lessons?
Yes, we do.
Well, I think I wouldn't mind seeing some of that.
Yes,
do you have a clip of that as well?
We've got quite a few trained professionals to teach guitar lessons. We've got a clip for you here.
All right, so we're going to see the clip in a few seconds. We just, what kind of instructors do you have? Like,
oh,
classical, professional?
Every type of music you can think of, we got that, university degrees and everything.
All right, so we're going to see the clip of the instructors teaching the students now, and here we go. Wow, that student seemed
That's
really
talent.
Good.
That is talent.
He seemed even better than the instructor,
well,
actually.
You know, we have really, really good instructors, but, you know, when you want to learn a guitar, you want to learn confidence as well. So our instructors go a little bit down low on their talent, so the students go way up.
I see. So your instructors are actually as good as your students, but they're just hiding it so the students
yes.
will feel more confident?
Yes. But that was one talented student.
All right.
He actually went off and joined a band.
Well, I think the audience is probably interested in seeing how you obtain your marvelous goods, so we're going to go to that clip now.
Finest guitar.
Very nice.
Good morning.
That looked pretty shady, I'm not going to lie.
That was
looked
not
like you were
shady
stealing
at all.
Those guitars.
That was the sunniest day we've ever traded.
But you were stealing those guitars. I didn't mean
that
shady
was...
literally. I meant shady figuratively.
That was not stealing. There was money involved.
Money paying for illegal guitars.
Who said they were illegal guitars?
You bought it out of the back of a trunk.
So don't you buy stuff out of the back of a truck?
No. Why? You ran from the police.
That wasn't us running from the police.
Then who was it?
The neighbor's dog next door bit the little girl the next door to them.
And the police were called. And you ran. Why did you run then?
The license plate stickers are from last month.
That's still illegal.
Not
we're
going
to go and
guitars.
Find out how you got your clip, your instructors on this clip so I can come to terms with this illegalness. Well, that was much more interesting. I see you got your instructors. Isn't that one of the two famous members of Lopsided and Balding?
Yes,
that
is.
About it?
But that is not who you think it is. That is actually Balding, the drummer.
Whoa, he's actually he was making street performer money, and
yes.
he decided to go to be an instructor.
Yes, we, you know, like I said, we get the top quality instructors. We roam the streets for the street vendors, and. We just get top quality. We'll offer top money as long as we have top quality.
Well, I'm not going to lie. I am impressed by his nobility. He was making all that money, and he went to be an instructor. But that's all the time we have for this segment. So I'm going to thank you for showing up, Mike.
Thank you.
Handshake here.
Matthew Bickerton.
We're going to cut to commercial, and when we come back, we're going to talk to the great Zucchini. So we'll see you then. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. We've got for you right now the great Zucchini. He's a magician, right out of Las Vegas, Nevada, fresh off his world tour of Earth. And so we're going to talk to him. Here he is right here. Give it up for the great Zucchini.
Thank you. Thank you.
So, Mr. Zucchini, that's a pretty interesting name. It's pretty original. How did you come up with it?
Funny you should ask about that. Once I got out of the academy, I pretty much needed some kind of snazzy name, like, you know, like some big thing that would make me famous. And so, I just decided after 3 months to name it after my wife, who in fact is a zucchini.
Wait a minute. Your wife is a zucchini?
Yep.
That's creepy and illegal.
Not in this state.
Oh, right. Anything goes Las Vegas, Nevada.
Yep.
So, what sorts of magic do you do, Mr. Zucchini?
I've done things from making little objects disappear to things as making the CN Tower vanish.
You made the CN Tower vanish? Well, we're going to see some clips of your magical prowess, and we're going to go to that right now. So here we go.
What we're going to do, we're going to go into the school right here, find some random students that have never seen me before, and show them a bit of the magic tricks, blow their mind. Let's go. Hi there. Would you two ladies like to see a little bit of a magic trick?
Sure.
Okay, now just to let the audience know, we have never seen each other before, right?
No, I don't even know your name.
All right, so here's what we're going to do. So, I'm just going to shuffle this card on the deck of cards, sorry, up a little bit. And I'm going to do this really cool little magic trick.
Okay,
so
one more time.
Okay. Got my cards done. Okay, so I'm going to pull these cards back one by one.
Okay.
And then just tell me when to stop.
Stop.
Okay, here's your card. I'm guessing 7 of diamonds.
Whoa! No way! I don't believe it. Do it again.
Yeah, okay,
again.
One more time. Okay, ready? Here we go.
Stop.
Okay. The 8 of diamonds.
Oh my god. That's BS.
Okay, and that was pretty interesting. That was some nice magic ability. I think we're going to go to TJ, the great Zucchini, who's going to show us a few of his magic tricks now. In person.
All right, yeah, so what I'm going to do here is I'm going to make this, wrong object. I'm going to make this little cap here that says concentration leads to success, but you know, I never believed those things. Using the salt shaker and a whole bunch of napkins. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put the stuff on top of the napkin here. I mean, I'm gonna put the napkins on top of the salt shaker, sorry. I'm gonna put this on top. I'm
gonna make sure your instructions are correct, too.
I know, I'm very sorry. That usually barely ever happens.
Don't want any magical mishaps occurring in the world. People vanishing.
I know, maybe I should take that fortune cookie to consideration then. Yes, I'm just gonna tap it three times. One, two, three. And apparently it disappeared.
Wow. Hello? Oh my god, wow, the salt shaker is gone too?
Apparently, I did not expect that.
That is incredible. Yeah. He made those disappear. I don't know how he did that. He's going to show us a little more magic. Adam, what do you think of that?
I saw this in Vegas, except the guy made everything but the salt shaker disappear, even the tissue paper.
Well, I guess I'm just having a good day today.
Wow, okay, so I think he's got another trick for us. We're going to see that.
All right, yeah, so what I'm going to do is going to get four.
What do you call this trick?
It's originally supposed to be called the Jumping Jacks, but some little punk kid snuck into my hotel room and took all my jacks. So now I have to use like four kings, so I'm just going to call them.
Oh, I hate punk kids.
I know, so I'm going to have to call them like the crappy kings or whatnot, whatever you want to call it. And I'm going to get four ordinary cards here. Okay, got stuck here. All right, yeah, so right here, I have the four kings, and I have the four ordinary cards. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to sort this out, put the king on top, put this one down, and in there, and one, two, three jacks. Okay, so now I'm just going to quickly show you that, you know, have no tricks up my sleeve.
Wait, they're kings in this performance, right?
Yes, there are kings in this performance, not jacks.
All right, just making sure.
Nor the queens either, no one likes them. And there you go, nothing in my sleeve there, sorry. All right, so one, two, shebang, and there we go.
Shebang is the magic word in this trick.
I know, it's just what makes things magically reappear and disappear. See, no kings. There they are.
Wow. That is very impressive. Big hand for the great Zucchini.
Thank you very much.
He's currently performing his one leg of his world tour in Las Vegas, Nevada, and you can go see a show for $49.99 a minute. It's pretty impressive. It's worth it. Every penny. I saw it, and it's not just because I'm rich. But that's the great Zucchini. That was pretty impressive. What did you think of that?
I had to mortgage my home to see it. It was worth it.
Oh, I imagine. Now it's magic. Magic makes everything better, even bankruptcy.
Oh, yes. I have to live in my Chevy now.
Okay. We're going to go to commercial, and this poor sap is going to be living in his Chevy for the rest of his life. Here we go.
I'll get you for this.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. I'm just going to tell you the commercial we just saw was actually a trailer for my good friend Matt Adams' new movie, The Truth Untold. And he's going to tell us a little bit about that right now. So, Matt, what is The Truth Untold all about?
Truth Untold is a story of depression and mishaps. It's much like the French farce movies that you see a lot, where everything just goes crazy wrong. Like, as you saw, I got beat up by one of my co-hosts, and then he died. And then at the funeral, on the way home from the funeral, I killed my friend.
I saw that. That was very melancholy looking. But, what, like, were there any mishaps involved in the actual filming? Did anything ever go wrong? Well,
thing is, you know when I got beaten up? That wasn't in the script. The director just thought it was funny.
Oh, my.
I was actually getting beaten up.
It was actually pretty hilarious.
Yeah. It happened.
I'm not going to lie.
It happened the last day. The guy beat me up, and he was like, you know what? Let's throw that in the beginning of the movie.
It sounds, it seems from the trailer you guys managed to read all of your lines perfectly, so you didn't have any mishaps with that?
Oh, well, one time when we were filming the car scene, it was going perfect. Beautifully. Straight, narrow, like an arrow. And then instead of saying championship, I said championship.
How could you make such a terrible mistake? I bet the director was furious with you. Absolutely furious.
He slapped me across the face, then spit in my eye. It stung.
That's
so bad.
That's fairly horrible, but I believe you deserved it. Uh-huh. And so we're going to go. I think Jessica's got a cake she's going to be making for us. We're going to find out how she does that. And we're going to go to that now.
Usually doesn't go in there, but okay.
Well,
why not?
Cake.
True.
He's got a good point. We also need some Pam. Lots of Pam.
All of this stuff. All of this stuff.
I agree.
This is actually cake mix, so I'll put this in.
Please, that would be necessary making cake. So.
Nothing would be complete without magic baking powder.
Well, it's magic. Of course it's necessary.
Yes.
You might want to even throw the container in there, just for good measure.
All of that in there, including the container.
I am having trouble. I can't get this open.
That's okay.
It's pretty tasty.
Oh, we need it.
Just throw it in like that.
Okay, we're good.
All right, and some berries.
Berries, always necessary for a cake. All
right. Throw that right.
You know what?
There.
I'm gonna add some freaking sorry.
We also need some sprinkles. All of the sprinkles.
You know what I noticed?
Not sure if I want to throw up.
You didn't bring any water.
Or lunge it.
We have
pop, people.
I'm not sure if this is making
me
hungry or sick.
This works.
That's
That's horrifying.
You're going to be very impressed.
That pour is impeccably slow.
All right.
I hope you're paying someone to clean this up.
Okay. Sweet.
Hmm.
Are we going to throw this?
Basic it's chemistry good. Is telling me Coke and baking soda, not a good idea.
We're going to throw this in the oven at 300 degrees for 8 hours. And after you've done that, this
wow.
is what you get.
With plastic and all?
Yes.
Amazing.
It came out much nicer than before. I mean, the last time I saw her make a cake, it looked like a lampshade when it was done.
It was even hollow.
Yeah.
With metal.
Pretty impressive.
That's it also really comes out of the oven with the cherry on top, too.
Oh, yeah. You'll love it.
Well, I guess all the berries kind of fused into one cherry and went on
yeah.
top.
Pretty awesome.
Okay. Well, that was Jessica and Brent with how to make cake on a limited budget. It was pretty impressive. It came out nicely. The cherry is gone. We're going to cut to commercial, and when we come back, we're going to hear a little bit from Lopsided and Balding about their new album. So let's go to that right now.
Lopsided Balding, brought to you by Vector Bar.
Lopsided and Balding. That was a song, Rhyme of the Ancient Mariner. Get over here. We're going to interview you guys. Get over here. Crazy rock and rollers.
How you doing?
Very good.
Okay, guys, I'm not going to lie. That was great. That was awesome.
Thank
that's
you.
From your new album, I think.
Yeah,
it stores Tuesday, September 31st.
Absolutely.
Yep.
Back in Black, it's called. It's a great album.
Wasn't that also an AC/DC album?
No.
It definitely was not.
Really? Oh, okay. So, how long, this album's been in the works for quite a while, almost as long as the new Guns N' Roses album. How long has it been in the works?
17 3/4 years.
That's pretty impressive, considering you're both only just 18.
Yeah, well, it's a triple track album.
Yeah.
It's got about 33 songs on it.
So, at $14.99, that's a steal. You're getting
two DVDs of pure music.
Two DVDs,
yeah.
Wow.
Got some live DVDs. Concerts on there, we got some music videos, all of our best.
We actually have this streaming right to the DVD.
Wow, that is like high tech, blows your mind, rock and roll.
17 3/4 years of high qualityness. Well,
yeah. What would you say is your favorite new song on the album, other than the Rhyme of the Ancient Mariner, which you just played for us?
Happy birthday.
That we took a classic song that everybody knows, and we electronicized it entirely, and it's completely new, and it's just fantastic.
We took all the elements of awesome out of that song and enhanced it 300%.
300%. That's not even physically possible. I'm that impressed.
Yeah, it's
great.
So, guys, it's been great talking to you. Lopsided and Balding, Back in Black, the new album out in stores Tuesday, September 31st. We're going to cut to commercial, and we're going to come back after that, and we'll talk to you guys for a bit then.
Thank you.
Thank you.
See you guys later.
This is a public service announcement from the Anti-Zombie Association of America. We are about to provide you with three tips to help you and your family out during a crisis. Tip one.
Always aim for the head.
Tip two.
Be sure it's actually a zombie. If the unfortunate event occurs and a friend or family member becomes a member of the undead, don't hesitate to attack.
But I'm not a zombie!
Dead Rising, in stores now.
Okay, guys, it's been a great show tonight. We've all had a lot of fun. We've learned how to make a cake. We learned that Coke is better than Pepsi. We learned Lopsided and Balding are awesome. And we also learned about Unky Straw's Music Emporium, and we learned a few card tricks. Tonight, I would say, was a brilliant success. We learned some great stuff, wouldn't you say, Adams?
Oh, yes, I would. I would say so as well. And also, thank you to the crew for making this
great
such,
crew,
amazing,
such a great show.
Amazing show.
Big applause. Our directors, our cameras, everyone. They did a great job. And our producer, Mr. Ivan Isipon, financing the entire project.
Fabulous.
Fabulous job. Fabulous. Great job. All right. Thanks for watching, guys. This has been the Late Bick Show, the special edition. And it's been a great show. Here we go. Lopsided and Balding going to play us off.
Oh, what?
Give it up for them.
Say what?